I'm Giselle Gotanco from the University of Santo Tomas Hospital, a second year resident, and I will be discussing a case of hybrid carcinoma of the nose. My objectives. My objectives are to present a unique case of hybrid carcinoma in a 62-year-old male presenting with nasal obstruction, to define hybrid carcinoma and discuss its the criteria for diagnosing such, to determine its incidence and in existing literature, and to present a rational approach on its diagnosis and management. So our patient is PO, a 62-year-old male, Filipino, 46-pack-year smoker, heavy alcoholic beverage drinker, who came in with a chief complaint of a 30-year history of nasal obstruction. This was accompanied by a progressively enlarging mass on the nasal bridge with nasal pain, anosmia, and epistaxis upon forceful sneezing. He underwent excision biopsy and 3 fractions of cobalt therapy. The post-operative course was uneventful until recurrence was noted 5 years prior. Biopsy was done 2 months prior, which showed undifferentiated carcinoma, and then the patient was advised surgery. On physical examination, the patient had swelling over the nasal bridge with no skin involvement. On nasal endoscopy, the nasal septum was found to be flared anterosuperiorly with intact mucosa. There were no masses seen on the nasal floor and at the nasopharyngeal area. CT scan showed an inflammatory subcutaneous tissue density underneath the nasal bridge and a slightly polypoid lesion in the right anterior superior nasal septum area. MRI showed ill-defined lytic bone lesions with solid mass component involving the both nasal bones, heart palate, alveolar process, and a right nasal polypoid nodule. So the patient underwent nasal bone and septum excision through a lateral rhinotomy incision. Histopathology revealed a hybrid or mixed tumor composed of an admixture of adenoid cystic carcinoma and squamous cell carcinoma, moderately differentiated. The patient underwent 13 fractions of radiotherapy but was eventually lost to follow-up. So currently, the patient has occasional blood-tinged nasal discharge with no recurrence of the mass and obstructive symptoms. The patient desires nasal reconstructive surgery, however, is limited by financial constraints. So this is the patient shown post-operatively. Here is a comparison of the patient pre-morbidly and post-operatively. So a hybrid neoplasm is a rare tumor entity composed of 2 different tumor entities, each of which conforming with an exactly defined tumor category, and they should arise from an identical origin within the same topographical area, and eventually would produce a single mass clinically and macroscopically. The common origin of the 2 tumors would be marked by a transitional zone. Each component of a hybrid tumor should occupy more than 30% of the tumor mass and must be separable from the other component. This is in contrast with a collision tumor, which is a meeting of 2 malignant neoplasms arising at independent topographical areas. And also, in contrast with basically differentiated tumors, which are repetitive mixtures of 2 cellular patterns with a corresponding term in the tumor classification. So a hybrid neoplasm is very rare, and only less than 30 cases have been described to date. It comprises 0.1 to 0.4 of all registered tumors. They have been known to have malignant and benign components. However, most reports have featured adenoid cystic carcinoma as the predominant histopathologic type. They have also been found in the following sites. However, there have been no published reports of an intranasal hybrid carcinoma. And also, there have been no reports of a combination of adenoid cystic carcinoma and squamous cell carcinoma. So, distinguishing the neoplasm with a higher histologic grade is the most crucial element in determining the aggressiveness of the tumor, its metastatic potential, and prognosis. On the other hand, the proportion of each constituent neoplasm does not play a role. So even if the more aggressive type comprises only 20% of the total lesion, they have been found to produce metastatic lesions. So in conclusion, due to a dearth of literature concerning hybrid carcinoma, prognostic assessment and clinical management poses challenges. Therefore, patients with a diagnosis of hybrid carcinoma should be followed up closely and for an extended period for monitoring of biologic behavior. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions? Was there any other adjuvant therapy that you gave? Chemo, radiation?
No, we only gave radiation therapy, and however, the patient did not complete it due to the effects of radiation.
How did you secure safety margin?
Doctor?
How did you secure safety margins of the tumor?
The tumor, in the histopathology report, the tumor had clear margins.
From everywhere?
Yes, doctor.